Well, the state of Utah now has a fourth congressional chair thanks to the 2010 census, which means it's time for legislators to figure out the new boundaries for Utah's political districts.
A new redistricting committee has the job of redrawing districts for the State Board of Education, as well as state and congressional districts. And 11 News reporter Danny Beckstrom is here with us. Danny, how's the committee shaping up?
Pretty good, actually. It has 14 Republicans and 5 Democrats, and has members from both the State House and Senate. Now, the committee members come from all over the state, so it's not just the Wasatch Front lawmakers calling the shots. The Speaker of the House and the President of the Senate are both members of this new committee. Some say the leaders joined the committee to push their personal agendas, but committee members like Brian King from Salt Lake say their membership proves the importance of the committee. The legislators say that the plan right now is to make slower growing districts larger, while the areas in which population has boomed in the last 10 years, they'll become smaller. Utah County seems to benefit the most from this boundary shifting process. Representative Ken Sumption from American Fork says that because of the population dynamics, Utah County should get a couple more seats during the redistricting. Now, the members of the new redistricting committee haven't set their schedule yet, but will be traveling all over the state so that Utahns can take part in the process. They can participate in public hearings, track the progress of the committee's work, and even work on their own proposals for the new districts. Getting a fourth seat in Congress is a pretty exciting thing for Utah, since it missed the opportunity in 2000 by only 800 people. Legislatures anticipate a special session in the fall in order to take action on the maps that they hope to have made up by that time.